Yeah, it's coming.
I think Rama is calling you.
Me?
Yeah.
Why should it be bureaucracy?
They are not a big percentage. They are not a big percentage, but they have much power.
I know this is artificial, but would you ask that question again?
Yeah, if I can think of it.
What percentage?
What percentage?
No, I think I started by saying, so Gorbachev's opposition in the country is the bureaucrats, is that right?
Bureaucrats, the remnants of the Stalinistic era. People who like power and who are not interested in the fate of the country and of the people.
Mm-hmm. And what percentage of the population is the bureaucracy?
I have no such information, but I think it is not much. They are not much. There are many of them, but people in general are much more. But people have no power, and they have it. They have positions. They have the possibility to disturb us, not to let us work, not to let us breathe normally. And they destroy the country. Mm-hmm. And Gorbachev, the country, elevates it.
So in general, would you say that Gorbachev is very popular within the country?
It depends between which part of the society. Mm-hmm. Between the intellectuals, yes. The writers, yes. Between the, I think the majority is for him. And against him are only people who like vodka.
But he has done much for alcoholic reform. I mean, he has helped many people.
Yes, because if not for Gorbachev, then the population of this country would degrade in 20 years completely. Degraded completely. We have a scientist, a very important scientist. His name is Uglov. He is a professor. He is a surgeon, and he specially worked on this topic. And he met with Gorbachev, and Gorbachev asked him, "How long will last this population if we don't do anything
about alcohols?"
And Uglov said, "20 years. After 20 years, there will be no population." All will be, the children are mongrels, yes?
Mongoloid.
Yes, they are idiotic. Mm-hmm. And it is degradation of the population. Mm-hmm. And so Gorbachev decided that he has to stop it or there is no future for the country. Mm-hmm. There was no alternative, he had to do it. And now there is much less tragedies on the fabrics because of alcoholization, less death, less hooliganism, and less idiotic children. And it is a very important step. And then it is not only that. Alcoholic persons, they can't very carefully. It is logical. No, first of all, no alcohol. Then they should spend their time not in articles about how to organize the free time of people that they are not, they'll not be interested in drinking if their time will be interesting. Because, for example, in Russia before we had interesting tradition, don't live now, and the young people don't know about it. It's not their blood, it's not their history, and it's very difficult. And they try to make something, but it must be done. No alternative.
This is the heart of it, yeah.
Yeah, and then during a long time, all what was spiritual, what was elevating, on the contrary, speaking about it, and not only Gorbachev and many others in our newspapers, in our...
Speaking about the loss of spirituality?
Not, in other words. In other words, but really such expressions like that now, как он говорит, духовность, это же есть spirituality. Yes, but in Russia it is not sounding in such a way like it is in English. But it is spirituality. It is elevating.
He's speaking of spiritual.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Never in our history we had such things, such expressions. We were so happy even to read it in the papers. We were very happy.
What's the Russian phrase again?
Духовность.
Elevating of the spiritual level of population. Yeah. And he speaks it, he pronounces it.
All the time.
Yeah. It's wonderful.
It must be, that gives the people a lot of hope, I would imagine.
Yes. A lot of hope. But it must be people who understand it. Not everybody understands it. Mm-hmm. Simple people, they don't understand. But in any case,
eventually they will.
They must.
I have a question about the age differentials. Is there a difference in your perception in the younger people or the older people in terms of the attitudes to a resistance of change or actually pushing the change? Is there
I wouldn't say it. I wouldn't say it. I think it is the most important thing is the background. If the young person or the old person is of certain social groups which understand it, then it doesn't import. For example, in my group, my students, my followers, they may be 18 years old and 80 years old. It doesn't import. They feel it, they understand it, they are of certain mentality, and they can strive for elevating, and I think it doesn't import at all. Mm-hmm. And between the opposition and bureaucrats, there may be young people, there may be old people, it doesn't import. The worst people are of my age, but I'm not so. Because they were created in the situation of Stalinism. And that was terrible. But we call it not only Stalinism, we call it Stalinshina. It is much, much more strong negative stress against it. It is a certain expression. And now Gorbachev is the opposite to it. He is helping to save the country from the remnants of this terrible time, oppressive time, and he is trying to not only economically, not only in agriculture, not only in the trade and in the industry to help the country to elevate, but as personalities, because we lost our dignity. Mm-hmm. We were not human beings. We were so. We had no dignity. And you know, in German, there is an expression, a person of such a type is like a bicycle rider. To the what is above, he is ducking, and for what is down, he is oppressing. And so such a type was created. When he saw a power, he was so. And when he saw that he can express power, then he was cruel. And this generation must die. And only when this generation dies completely out, only then it will be possible to create a new country and a new population. We are still not so old. I don't want to say that everybody of us is so, but it is the most terrible age.
What can we do as U.S. citizens, and what can the U.S. government do to support what Gorbachev is doing?
Not only by meditating. Meditating is very important. Praying is very important. But not only that. The more you come here, the more you have here personal contacts, personal friendships, the better. Understand? And not only that. In two lines you have to work. In personal contacts, the more the better, then you understand better this country, our situation. But your personal contacts must be with people who are not afraid. If you have contacts with people who are afraid, you will not get the real information. But you are clever enough.
Is part of it helping them, moving them from a place of fear, helping them understand that they can?
Yes, try. That in official organizations tell much more about your speak much about your situation, about your possibilities, about your work, about your activities, about your peace work. It's very important. Explain to them how you fight for the peace. It's completely different as they do. Yeah. And it's very important for them to know about it. Mm-hmm. Yes. And in two lines, official contacts, the more the better. Personal contacts, but with clever people, the more the better. And in quantity, the more you come here, not only Americans, from all the countries, the better. Because it will help to make the tension less and to make friendship and love more. Love.
What kinds of things do you think we as Americans could ask our government to do, the U.S. government to do, in relation
can't even
to,
give it to do
your government?
Yeah, our government.
For us.
To ask your government, because our government...
No, we don't ask them to do anything.
Your government. Mm-hmm. To organize more groups to come here, mm-hmm. to facilitate your possibilities, perhaps financially or something like that, mm-hmm. to facilitate your possibilities to visit us more and more, like a rain, like a yes. storm, like a yes, it is very important. And to press, but not to press like that, we will that, you will that, no, not in that meaning, with love, with friendship, smiling, but insistent. Yes.
In order to convince the U.S. government, one has to have answers to some of the objections that are being put up on Glasnost, I think. And one of the objections is this real, or is this a facade? Is this a new ploy for...
I understand. I have read such materials. I know.
Yes.
People bring me some American materials, and I think it over, because it's very important, yes. It depends on the persons. It seems to me that for Gorbachev it is real, that he is sincere. I feel, it seems, I may be mistaken, I don't know, but I think that he is absolutely serious about it and sincere about it. And he is very much concerned about the future of our country. And he is perhaps the only one, the first one, who is really concerned not in the power of the country, not in oppressing other countries, but really in elevating this country to another level and to making it free. And a country or a person who oppresses others is not free, is never free. And if he wants our country, our people to be free, and he doesn't want oppression, but he is limited by certain circumstances and he can't do everything what he wants to do. And so we believe he's sincere. But this story about what your questions, I don't want to repeat the word, it is still not so as it should be because of this opposition, because of this bureaucracy. Not because that he is not sincere. Because it's difficult to re-educate people to think in another manner. He said, now we need a new thinking. He said, we need really a new thinking, but it is difficult to impose new thinking on persons who were interested only in their power. And who doesn't, from these persons who speak so much about interests of the country, most of them will sell this country when they go abroad. Exactly they. But we criticize like we criticize our child. Because we want the child to be happy. And if we don't criticize, then the child will not be educated. And so it is very important, this type of... And before, criticizing person was an enemy. And now many people say, and he says too, and many articles say, officially in our press, we are so happy about it, that the contrary, people who criticize are needed by the country, because without criticizing, we can't take out the negative sides. Criticizing, seeing them, we can help against them. And if we don't speak, then they will persist, they will be like our bureaucracy.
What does Gorbachev need to learn that he hasn't learned well enough yet?
I think he doesn't need anything. I think he has everything in him. He has understanding. He has cosmical channeling. He has a big heart. He is very very sensitive. I'm sure of it. I have proofs of it. But he has a difficult position because still not all the power is in his hands. But much of this power is in the hands of the old generations, of my generation. And he has to be diplomatical. And so, look, from this point of view, on everything what he is saying, many of his saying is not because the country needs it, but because the bureaucracy needs it. Mm-hmm. And he can't proceed. In the beginning, I was very impatient, like many of us. I said, if he doesn't let go my friends who wait 14 years to see their mother in Jerusalem, so I don't believe him. But then I understood that's not right. He can't do everything. He can't go across all these monsters. He can't help all of us. He is doing everything exactly in the speed which is needed. For example, another example, but you can compare. My friends invited me to Baku in the Caucasus, to read lectures about press ecology. They have read much of yoga, much of many things, they know, but I was very careful in giving them information. I gave them drop by drop, little by little. They said, it is your drop speed, the speed on drops, yes? And they were very angry with me. Why I didn't say the full truth immediately? But they wouldn't be able to digest it. In spite of knowing yoga, it's not enough to when people has to understand the full truth, yoga is not enough. And same is here with Gorbachev. He has this drop speed. He needs exactly that speed. He has not only diplomacy, but he has intuition.
We can, if our committee, our group, I just feel if we could create a new thought guidebook that was an amalgamation of the simplest, cleanest thoughts to assist with this drop-by-drop process and write that in Russian and make it available to Gorbachev and make it available to anybody who wants it. It was just a simple little primer on the steps of the new age, new thought. Mm-hmm. You know how it is with ourselves. So when you read something like that, how it inspires you and causes you to go to the next step. And that would be something that would be a good project for us too. And I think it would be good if somehow, and I'd like to declare right now that we do this, that we have the ability and the opportunity to meet with him personally and support him and let him know that we feel the same way and that he's not alone.
Yeah.
That we
don't tell him that he is not alone. All he will understand that we think that he is alone. Understand?
Yeah.
Tell him.
The idea
yeah. Tell him that you are with him.
Yes.
But don't tell him that for him not being alone, or he will feel it. Understand?
Yes.
Right. It is a little shade.
You're right. You know, it's more than us saying anything at all. It's just being with him and just letting him know that we are there.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Much love. Much support.
We do that now.
Yes.
Through meditation.
Yes.
I read this the other day, Barbara, and I was thinking when Bernard asked you about what do we say to Americans, you know, Americans say, is glasnost real? Isn't it a ploy? Will it last? Things like that. And an American editor who exchanged with a Soviet editor, and they wrote articles alongside each other to be published in Oganyuk. And
interesting, if they publish it.
Right. And what the American author said was... He asked the question, he said, should America cooperate with glasnost? Because if glasnost works, the Soviet Union becomes stronger, and if you're into competitive mentality, then, and what he said is the real question we should ask ourselves, that Americans need to decide is, if Gorbachev does not succeed, who will take his place? And do we want to deal with that kind of person?
I understand.
And for American thought, that is...
Yeah, I understand. I have read such articles, American articles. I know this. I understand their position, too. But I think if Gorbachev wins completely, there will be no enemies. There will be no need to be afraid of anybody.
But you see, Americans can't hear that.
Yeah, Americans will not have...
Yeah, but that's our job, too.
Yep.
I mean, that's definitely what... is part of our work.
Yes, that is, if he wins, there will be harmony here. If he wins, glasnost will give the possibility to everybody to pronounce the real situation, and it may be changed for the best. And if it must, the question is not that the country will be stronger. The country will be more just and more full of harmony. And then there will be no need to be afraid of this country. It will not be enemy to anybody. There will be no Afghanistan, no Poland, no anything, and there will be all normal. Only so may be a country under Gorbachev when he wins. And so there will be no reason to be afraid of. And there will be no question about who is stronger.
Right.
Everybody will be friends. It is idealistical, perhaps, from my part. But it seems to me the only possible way now. The history is now going on very, very, not jumping, but